for real this time. Funny. Gracious me. Thank you. Yeah. Okay. And then the surprise from yesterday. Thank you. Okay. Oh, good. Awesome. There you are. All right. Thank you. Why couldn't I do that yesterday? One. I did it first try. With super missiles to spare, too. I did much better at aiming and dodging. Right, I mean, it's 100%, so it should, right? I don't know. Bad luck. I was being really sloppy yesterday. Right? Right? Exactly. Well, that's interesting. It's the fusion. Let's see. Okay. Is 100%. Thank you very much. Alright. Awesome. So, now. I'm gonna switch over to. Nice, nice, nice.
Yay!
Alright, so now we're gonna switch over to AM2R. So give me one moment here. Gotcha, gotcha. Makes sense. Got to hit load. There it goes. Oh, right. I should change this. Oh, wow. Okie dokies. Down while aiming to choose direction. Aim diagonally using two separate buttons. Press back button. What? Press up or down. Aim diagonally using two separate buttons. That'd be the L and R, right? Metroids. Numerous incidents in the past have brought to light the highly destructive power of these life forms, spreading fear across all known planetary systems. Hoping to secure peace in the galaxy, the Galactic Federation orders the extermination of the Metroid species. I was the best candidate for the job. Once again, I find myself standing alone against the Metroid menace. What horrors await me within the depths of their homeworld? Right. Oh, the music. Alright, so welcome back to SR-388. Sure, I got you, yeah. It's more techno. It's so weird to feel the controller vibrant when I get hit. Right, yeah. Okay. So life refill stations are totally gone. Okay. I presume they've been replaced with something else. Save stations are full recharges. Good. Aha. Oh, I guess it showed the red doors on the map. Okay. I liked that feature. Oh. Right, that's right. It starts with missiles. Yeah, okay. So A triggers it? Oh, it's a save station. Save station. Scythe sent me the file on my strike and give that to you. Right, yeah, because Nintendo knocked this down because they were coming up the DS game. Oops. Hello. Entry move? Ooh, come here. Gotcha. Ooh, nice. Log entry. Oh, you can place markers, so that's cool. I assume this is locked. Oh, hello! What is this? Okay, gotcha. So they kept the geography, but not the actual item. Funny. Mission briefing. Let's do this. Primary objective. Exterminate all Metroid organisms on planet SR-388. Secondary objectives. Locate and bring assistance to the Galactic Federation Research and Rescue. Ooh, okay. Something new. Planet SR-388. Planetary designation SR-388, a remote planet absent on most galactic charts. Federation research indicates it is the natural homeworld of the Metroid species. Its outer crust is hollowed out with massive cave systems which are home to an ecosystem that has yet to be fully studied. The first expedition, SR-388, revealed the existence of Chozo ruins. Oh, okay. Interesting. The research team. For years, the Federation declared SR-388 unsafe to initiate new expeditions. However, after recent orbital scans failed to detect any Metroid presence on the planet's surface, well, that was a major fail, wasn't it? The dispatch of a research vessel was finally approved. The crew's mission was to inspect the region where the species was first encountered and reaffirm that none remained. Their next objectives were to explore the nearby Chozo ruins and study SR-388's other wildlife. Communication with the team was cut off and only a distress signal managed to reach HQ. Rescue team. The search and rescue team is an elite combat group consisting of heavily armed soldiers. Their mission, locate and extract any surviving personnel from the missing research team. The group reported finding a specialized energy sensor at a campsite of the missing team. Its data confirmed the Federation's suspicions. Metroid still thrived within the planet. These findings were sent to headquarters to be analyzed while the group continued their search for survivors. Contact was soon lost with them as well. The data sent to headquarters revealed an approximate number of Metroids remaining on SR-388 and was ultimately used to develop a scan module for your power suit. This allows the detection of nearby energy readings unique to the species. Okay. Metroid species. The dominant species of SR-388, Metroids hunt for any form of energy found in natural or synthetic organisms, leaving behind deceased husks after feeding. They are highly resistant to conventional weapons and possess great adaptability in foreign environments. Estimates suggest a small number of Metroids set loose on a populated planet would lead to the extinction of any present life forms. As such, they've drawn much attention from space pirates, who have repeatedly tried to use them as biological weapons, much to their own demise, as history has shown. Life cycle. Scans on native Metroids reveal their most common form in prior incidents is merely the species' larval stage. While there are records of extreme mutations triggered by space pirates using abnormal stimuli, the Metroid homeworld of SR-388 is seemingly the only environment where the species can naturally transform. Okay. That's extreme mutations of abnormal stimuli. Oh, okay. The Alpha Metroid has gained immunity to cold temperatures. Well, that's not good. The loss of several nuclei within its green membrane has left it vulnerable to concussive weaponry. A plated exoskeleton partially covers it. This organism emerges from the molting of its larval form. Though aggressive, it is relatively weak at this stage, and its new appendages have yet to grow to their full length and strength. And then the Chozo. The Chozo were an ancient and mysterious avian race, incredibly advanced. They colonized many worlds, spreading their message of peace throughout the universe. There are historical records and legends of the Chozo visiting other races with whom they shared their knowledge and wisdom. These brief encounters led many primitive cultures to their present-day glory. Some say they helped consolidate the very foundations of the Galactic Federation. The fate of this race is unknown. Evidence suggests they slowly vanished from the cosmos over the course of centuries. All that remains on each planet they inhabited are the ruins of their once glorious civilization. And hostiles. Not much is known about SR-388's ecosystem. Prior reports describe the fauna as being very hostile. Nearly all observed animals have been carnivores, with even the smallest species showing dangerous traits. The harsh environment and the presence of so many predators may have forced an evolutionary arms race, perpetuating a cycle of violence. Extreme caution is advised. Cool. Okay. Vibrations, the acid is going down. Oh, hey, you can actually see it going down. That's cool. Earthquakes. The massive cave system is located between two tectonic plates, largely flooded by an extremely dense and caustic substance similar to magma. The recent earthquake has altered the cave layout, and the hazardous substance has drained to lower levels. The cause of the earthquake is unknown. Initial orbital scan of SR-388 detected no instability within this region. So we're making it a coincidence. That's funny. Oh, I don't watch it. Popular fan theory is that the Queen Metroid is causing earthquakes because she's mad at you. Oh, that makes sense, yeah. That's right, that makes sense. Oops. Oh, okay. I really like the not having to confirm that I want to save. It's like, I stepped on a save station, what do you think I want to do? Oh, that's cool, it changes color. Neat. Item that lets you grab those. Scanning. Energy pattern scan for Metroid Zero. Oh, that's cool. I like that. Shoot it without pause. Nice. Okay. Well, you know what? Let's see. This is place marker. Nice. Oh, that's cool. It's the marker from Zero Mission, but I have control of it. That's awesome. That maybe? Golden Temple. The Golden Temple. This temple stands at the base of a hollow mountain. The statues, carved stones, and its solid design attest that the structure was built to be a sanctuary, possibly with religious significance. The temple has withstood the test of time, showing the building knowledge and experience of the Chozo. Scans detect the presence of stationary robotic entities, placed at strategic points within the structure. No control signals are detected. These units are operating autonomously. Okay. I like the decision to make it a golden temple when in the original game was black and white. That's cool. Give me spike ball. Give me spike ball. Oh, that's true on this Super Game Boy, huh? Oh, and the Game Boy Color. Oh, I remember those things. Oh, but you can only have one marker at a time. That's interesting. Does it repeat the okay? What on earth? Give me that E-tank. I want the E-tank. Yeah. Oh, okay. Oh, heck. Right, right, of course. Oh, that's neat. I like that. Okay. This is the collectible thing? Makes sense. Oh dear. Ooh, what's this? Spider Ball! Yes, one button. Down one more to enable jump to disable. Hold aim to enable. There it is. Thank you. Oops. Oh, look at those spikes, okay. Hello. Oh, I have to Goodness gracious. What is this? Later. Too many. Yes. Oh, charge me. Oh, really? It sucks in... Oh, really? Oh, that is neat. That is cool. That connects to where I found the spider ball. Oh, okay. Okay, so this doesn't really make that all that easy to do. And that spoils it. Funny. So I guess I should go back to my marker. Thank you. that's a morph ball tunnel. That's interesting. Why? There's nothing in there. Breeding grounds. Oh, that sounds good. This area spans a custom-built ecosystem that favors the growth of Metroids. The terrain itself is dangerous. Tendrils growing along the ground release extremely corrosive chemicals. Opportunistic predators and scavengers can recognize this as an ideal feeding ground, taking advantage of injured or dead animals. The presence of at least one Metroid is expected when venturing in these habitats. The tendrils are determined to be of artificial origin. Synthesized through technologically advanced methods, they absorb nutrients from dead matter. I know you're in here. I recognize this shape. Let's go. Where are you? There you are. Don't mind if I get the first hit. Thank you very much. Almost there. I know, I wanted to mess with the infinite bomb jump. Crimson Potato God, how you doing? Yeah, it is my first time playing this, and yes, I am enjoying this. What the heck? This sentry deploys spiked barriers and corners targets in its firing range. Due to archaic design constraints, it only operates at low power, preventing the simultaneous use of its shield and mobility systems. It also consists of energy weapons with unique patterns. The robot was calibrated to detect foreign creatures bearing stolen equipment. Recent earthquakes seem to have damaged the traction of the unit and spiked barriers. Despite these complications, it remains a considerable threat. Yes, I have. Grown being cleared out. Without messing up the spider bomb this time. No! Oh, did he? I haven't been on a ladder today. Oops. Really mean. That's cool. That's awesome for him. Sheesh. I should probably just wait till I have the morph jump. I would have the morph jump. Scanning environment. 7 Metroids detected in the area. Oh, hello. Surprise. Facility at the center of this reservoir filters and pumps water through enormous pipelines. These pipes come out of the complex and disappear into the surrounding rocks, presumably to supply other buildings further down the cave system with clean water. Though abandoned, most of it remains functional. Robotic activity is detected inside. Spider ball is slow. Hello. Wow. Sheesh. Background looks really good. Oh, what does that one? Arachnus. A territorial organism, its armored hide is very resilient and requires at least a high voltage discharge to harm it. Attacking with anything less will agitate the creature. Grin in rage, it will roll to a bow and attempt to ram its aggressor. Bombs might be able to propel in this state. Its saliva has flammable properties, and its claws can vibrate at high frequencies to launch sonic waves. Scan detects it has acquired or chosen a relic, granting it unnatural vigor. Okay. Ow! Stunning. Number one. Great. Okay, do I need to be bombing him into the electric wall? Ooh. to this when I have more health. Alright, we're gonna try this one more time. Oh, that's a new move. Thank you. Hello! I'm doing fine. How are you doing? Because I die a lot. Oh, cool. Oh, not yet anyway. I just started this game. What is this? Oh! High jump boots. Interesting. I'm enjoying it very much. Stopping by. Oops. Hope you have a good night. Well, we'll see what happens. Hey, Zoro, by the way. Thank you. goodness gracious, I hate these robots. Well, I mean, now that Samus Returns is out and has been out for like 5 years, apparently, I guess that makes a difference. Oh, I can charge me. Look at that. Ow. Yeah, I know, there's a pipe in the floor. Oh, I hate that thing so much. Just try to figure out how to get into that pipe. Because it goes down into here. Oh, you can listen. These things. Wow, okay. This area took on a massive difficulty spike, didn't it? Yeah, there we go. Jump back. you stop hanging so low to the floor, please? Thank you. Wow, this fight's going worse than it did last time. Jeez. Thank you. Okay, you have to go outside to get that one. Wave beam. Nicer. Uh-huh. Oh, wait, there's a... Oh, okay, I see it now. All right. Okay. I was afraid of that.
Stuff.
Yeah, I do remember this room. It's black and white, that's neat. That's cool, I like that. That's a nice touch. Oh, hello. Oops. Oh, that's interesting. Yeah, we can help. We're gonna go try that thing. Makes sense. Thank you. duck. Oh, you have to jump over here. Oh. Oh, what is that? Ow. Agony. Oh. Oh, thank you, Springball. Yeah. Woo! Sounds good. Come on. Thank you. Thank you. Oh, I see. Oh, hello. Oh, hello. Oh, okay. That's way closer than you see. Gamma Metroid. This stage of Metroid can now transfer negative charge from its nervous system into the horns, releasing electric arcs capable of disrupting weapon fire. The membrane containing its nucleus remains vulnerable, but the Gamma Metroid's exoskeleton has expanded for additional protection. Although its legs have reached the maximum length, they are unsuitable for locomotion. Instead, they can serve to capture prey and drain their energy. Oh. Gamma, Of course, I did them out of order. Oh, there it is. Thank you. Stop there. Alright, this is a lot of fun. I like the way they expanded it. It's really good. Alright, so yeah, we will pick this back up on Sunday. And with that, we're going to go and call it there for the week. Thank you everyone so much for watching. Hope you had a good time. And it's the canonical Metroid 2. And you can't change your mind. And yeah, so yeah, we'll be back to do this on Sunday. Have a great week, everybody. Bye!